FM News. On point. News on XFM. I'm Chris Tim. The Forum for Democratic Change presidential candidate Patrick Amuriat-Oboy has criticized the Electoral Commission's chairman Simon Biabakama for banning people from accessing the polling stations with phones and cameras. This follows Biabakama's remarks yesterday that people will not be allowed to access the polling stations with phones and cameras except journalists. However, Amuriat says that this will be the beginning of the rigging of votes. He adds that as the opposition, they have jointly signed an MOU agreeing to secure their votes.
I see Biabakama's statement really being out of order. He issues such a statement without citing the provisions of the law under which he premises this order. And so for us as the FDC, we are encouraging our people to keep at the polling station. I believe that it's healthy for the entire opposition to do this. This mischievous manner of trying to arm-twist the population is something we'll not accept. And we do this recognizing the constitution and the laws governing the election process and the voting day and all the provisions that are given therein.
The National Unity Platform, NUP, presidential candidate Robert Kyagulanyi has defended the flying out of Uganda of his four children, saying they have been living under constant fear. While speaking in Mbale this morning, Bobi Wine told journalists that there were plans to have his kids kidnapped as a way of coercing him into submission. Last night, social media was awash with pictures of Chagulanyi's children at Entebbe Airport, ready to set off to the US ahead of next Thursday's general elections here in Uganda. He said last year there was a direct attack on a car transporting two of his children from school, forcing him to change their schools. Meanwhile, police have arrested over 10 of Chagulanyi's campaign team members as they were heading to Namayingo district for his campaign rally. Jinja Road Police here in Kampala are investigating a case of domestic violence in Banda, where a lady accuses her husband of mistreatment. Nancy Mbabazi, a resident of Banda Zone B in Chida Municipality, opened a case against her husband, Solomon Senyonjo, for child neglect and torture. She requested the police to intervene and appeal to other authorities to come in and help her restore peace.
No, this man came the other day at home, very drunk. He said, banging the door, abusing me. I'm not a good woman. My parents are stupid. He's going to kill me with my kid. I'm komanyoko. He said so many things, shouting in front of neighbors, banging the door and what? And window. So I ignored to open. I said that I'm not opening for you when you're behaving like that. You're very drunk and I cannot open for you like that. Why are you abusing me? Why are you making noise? Cut what I want here in police. It has become too much. You live not helping my children, but it has become violent. This man now reached an extent of threatening. First, he kept threatening me, which is affecting my baby.
Mary Amunyo, the officer in charge of child and the family protection unit at Jinja Road Police Station, says that investigations are going on and has appealed to the public to always get solutions.
In this issue of domestic violence within the home, really, it is too much. Most of the people are being beaten. Most of the women are being chased away from homes. They're being battered terribly. I appeal to the public over there. They should really not take law in their hands. They should find a solution how to solve the issue within their homes. I've summoned the man to come today, of which he said that he will come with the brother along with him, so that we solve this issue amicably.
Now in technology news, Amazon has become the latest U.S. tech giant to pledge billions of dollars to support affordable housing. The e-commerce giant said it was starting a fund of more than $2 billion U.S. dollars aimed at creating or preserving 20,000 homes across three regions in the United States. The money will be used primarily to support low-cost loans for moderate-income families, it said. The effort follows years of rising home and rental prices in the U.S. Home prices have climbed more than 6% each year since 2012, despite muted wage growth for most workers. Before the pandemic, rental rates had also risen steadily, driving a shortage of affordable units. In sports, the Miami Heat and the Boston Celtics played with a heavy hat on Wednesday after seeing the U.S. Capitol stormed by hundreds of supporters of the outgoing President Donald Trump. The U.S. Capitol is an equivalent of the Ugandan parliament. Now, the riots came a day after prosecutors declined to bring charges against the police officer who shot Jacob Blake. The incident in August caused the NBA to postpone games in protest. A joint statement by Boston and Miami players read, 2021 is a new year, but some things have not changed. On that note, that's a quick roundup of the news on XFM.
XFM News on point.